The mining industry is capital intensive. As a result, mining personnel have become extremely skilled at incremental, small step innovations that improve productivity and lower costs, but are achievable within existing built capital constraints. However, the industry is facing numerous challenges, including declining grades, water shortages, the need to reduce energy consumption, social license to operate, as well as the usual market variations. To respond effectively to these challenges, mining companies have recognized the need to adopt radically different technologies and engage in disruptive innovation. Disruptive innovation in the mining context involves developing and implementing new technology that requires entirely new equipment, skills, and workflows. The nature of newness is that there will be aspects that are not possible to anticipate and manage. These unknown unknowns make disruptive innovations high risk. In order to address these challenges, our team at the Queensland University of Technology, in collaboration with the Cooperative Research Centre for Optimising Resource Extraction, have developed the Organisational Process Model for Technology Adoption in Mining, OPM-4-TAM. This tool was designed to assist senior leaders and relevant decision makers engaged in disruptive innovation to minimize the unknown unknowns by engaging relevant stakeholders, including technology users, in the process of technology identification, development, and implementation. The OPM-4-TAM recommends a range of practices to guide leaders' decisions of where to focus development activities that help equip a team to manage the risks associated with disruptive innovation. The OPM-4-TAM was developed by synthesizing the most recent academic literature on innovation and change management and considering the Australian technological readiness levels. The tool integrates the latest research with mining practices so it can be readily used in the mining context. The model was further enriched by insights from 25 in-depth interviews with experts from the Australian mining sector. They were chosen due to their extensive experience with implementing change in mining firms and their experience with the practices that led to successful technology adoption. The organizational process model for technology adoption in mining consists of three phases: ideating and strategizing, developing and piloting, implementing and embedding. Each phase contains three steps. Each step contains a suite of practices that support successful technology adoption. Phase one, ideating and strategizing, guides mining organizations through the process of recognizing the need for a new technological solution and deciding on a strategic response. It includes three steps. Identifying opportunities involves scanning the internal and external environment for potential problems and opportunities. Examining options involves searching internally and globally for new technical developments. Making the case involves developing and communicating a robust business case. Phase two is developing and piloting. This phase guides development of the potential technological solution to address its specific operational needs. Practices in this phase are focused on three main steps. Developing, testing, piloting involves a multi-stakeholder team co-designing and co-executing development work. Proving the concept using iterative propose, test, improve cycles at increasing scales to progress the solution. Preparing to implement involves senior management adjusting team composition, roles and KPIs, and handing ownership of the solution over to the site. Phase three is implementing and embedding. The new technology is implemented in operations and over time is embedded as the new normal. Steps underpinning phase three are transitioning to new operations involves redesigning workflows, role descriptions, and KPIs. New routine production involves adjusting organizational levers to support the embedding of the technology. Scaling out involves exploring and assessing how the adopted technology could deliver value elsewhere in the organization. Senior leaders and relevant decision makers involved in any phase of technology adoption can use OPM-4-TAM as a checklist of practices that support technology adoption. To use OPM-4-TAM, first, identify which phase of technology adoption the project is currently in. then refer to the OPM-4-TAM guide and find the table of supporting practices for that phase. Compare these practices with current project activities to help inform planning for technology adoption activities. A use case setting out how a manager engaged in the developing and piloting phase of technology adoption uses OPM-4-TAM is available on our project website. OPM-4-TAM can be used by itself or preferably in conjunction with the Innovation Culture Assessment Tool, ICAT, for additional support and to ensure optimal technology adoption. To learn how to use ICAT and OPM-4-TAM together, click on the link provided. To find out more about OPM-4-TAM, ICAT, and our latest research, including previous videos in this series, visit us on the QUT website.